Hey everyone, this is Alex from csun. I am going to be addressing with you today Zoom bombing. If any of you have seen any stories on the news so far, going over something that they call Zoom bombing, what this is, to explain what a Zoom bomber or a Zoom bombing means, is when you are having a Zoom meeting with your class or with your students or with your group, it has been reported that a couple of people at different universities have entered into meetings randomly and began either sharing their screen and showing inappropriate offensive content or saying verbally offensive or inappropriate things. So to prevent anyone doing that and sort of sabotaging your class, I want to go over a few things. The text that I have copied here is actually from a document that's been going around that's being shared between multiple universities, and I really appreciate that some people already had the time, taken the time to go over a few of these things. So what is a Zoom bomber? Zoom is a synchronous live web conferencing tool that's fantastic. However, in this time of disruption, there have been an increased likelihood that you may have uninvited attendees show up in your meetings and deliberately try to derail it. So what we're going to talk about in this video are some tips and tricks that I will show you what to do and how to sort of just set up your account to be a little bit more secure so that you're not caught off guard and so that you don't find yourself in one of these situations. So the first thing that they outlined in this information right here that I thought was useful to share is a few tips. Tip number one, this too shall pass. Many educators have been using synchronous tools like Zoom for years without experiencing any issues. So that's the first thing that I want to point out. Don't be deterred from using Zoom. Zoom is a fantastic resource that we have available to us, and even more so now in this current time. So please definitely still use Zoom. Having said that, I want to point out that you do not need to always have a synchronous live web session. Zoom allows you to record a session, which you could actually do having a Zoom meeting by yourself. You could share your screen and you could record that meeting and narrate through a PowerPoint or something, just like you would be lecturing in a normal class. And then you can upload that video to Box and then share that onto Canvas in like a playlist style of videos. So if you feel more comfortable recording yourself using Zoom and sharing your screen and narrating a PowerPoint or any content that you want to go over that way, that's another way that you could use Zoom too. There's no right or wrong way. You don't have to do live Zoom sessions. And also another option is always doing Zoom office hours, where you could just be using Zoom to meet with students one-on-one whenever they choose to set up an appointment with you or whenever you designate time for office hours or something like that. So again, that's three different ways that you could be using Zoom, and whatever way you feel most comfortable with is what we encourage you to try out. So going forward, step number two, or tip number two, trust your students. This is a very stressful time for students too. So while you should take precautions to ensure your Zoom meetings are attended by only your students, be careful that your students don't interpret your actions as a sign of distrust in them. Just a thoughtful tip on this one here. And the last one, this is actually something that we are thankfully already doing. So this is an important one. Tip three, share links in your password protected course. This tip should be all you need to do. Zoom bombing happens when a meeting link has been shared publicly. So that's also a very important thing to take into consideration. We are not really publishing any shared links in public places, any meeting links in public places. What we've been teaching everyone to try to do is upload your Zoom meetings into a Canvas module. So simply by having the students logging into Canvas, the only people that are going to have access to your meeting information should be csun students, and then the only people who should be even allowed to be looking at your course material are your own students in your own class. So that should already right there sort of knock out the threat of anybody joining your meeting uninvited or unwanted, because I think what had been reported on the news was that hackers or somebody were joining in meetings that were also, the meeting ID was publicly shared on a website somewhere, so it was publicly available. So anyway, To move on with that though, we have a few things that are some just in case tips that we're going to move on to. So if a disruptive uninvited attendee appears in your meeting, the first thing you should do is take a deep breath. Focus on managing the situation as opposed to engaging with the individual. Follow these suggestions. Stop the unwanted screen sharing. Share your own screen right away. You are the host and you may take screen sharing over from attendees. Number two, stop unwelcomed webcam or video sounds by clicking on manage participants from the toolbar. So I'll show you what that looks like. If you go to start a meeting and you go to manage participants down here, let me join in this meeting really quick and I'll show you what that will look like. So now that I'm in here, actually I'll turn the video on. So now that I'm in here, I'm recording this in my car for quiet and distraction purposes. So if I go up here, I can actually withdraw my co-host permission because I'm the same person. So now I'm the host here, and this is me as also a participant. So as you can see, if I go to manage participants and open up this list, and I click or right click on more or on my name, I can go to stop video, or I can go to remove, or I can even go to put on hold. And if I were to be put on hold, that kind of removes me from the room and kind of puts me in limbo. So again, you can do several different things. You can stop someone's video, which will just turn off their video, so you can control that. And then you can also remove somebody from the room altogether. Another thing that I want you to note that in the meeting here, if you go again from manage participants, if you open up manage participants, you can mute all and unmute all from here. But also under the more tab, you can actually, this option here is checked, allow participants to unmute themselves. I'm going to uncheck that. So that now says that participants cannot unmute themselves. And so if I go to mute all, then that means that the students won't be able to override that. Another thing that you want to think about doing is locking the meeting. So maybe 10 minutes into the meeting or something, just in case you have anyone who's straggling or anyone who's tardy to the Zoom class, you can lock the meeting. And what that will do is that will prevent anybody from joining your meeting once you have began your lecture. So that will right there also prevent anybody from taking over control. So those are a few really helpful things right under manage participants. You can also go to share screen here. And if you click on this little menu that pops up, you can also decide who can share. If you want participants to be able to share, such as doing presentations or group presentations, you might want to have this turned on. And then that way, if you have that turned on, then the students will be able to share. And you can also go over here and lock the meeting. So that now if anybody wants to share any inappropriate content, you'll see their name associated with that. And if anyone in your class tries to do anything, hopefully nobody will, but just in case if somebody does, you can report them to student affairs or something like that. And if they want to, you know, do anything inappropriate, that's on them. But luckily you as the host now know there are a few things that you can do to ensure that you will be the only person that can be sharing your screen and making sure that you won't be caught off guard by anybody uninvited. So again, you can just make it so that you are the only person, the host can share their screen. And then also if you go into the website dashboard, again, if you log into your Zoom profile and then underneath profile and meetings over here on the left-hand menu, if you go down to settings, you can actually also view some of these settings. And actually there's a whole bunch of other settings that you might come across and find useful here. So I definitely encourage you to look through your meeting settings. But if you are in basic meeting settings here, that will auto align you to this section. And if you just scroll down a little bit, you can also change this here as well, who can share. So you can do this on the website dashboard and also from the app itself. And there's also a few other things that you might just want to check out if you haven't explored using breakout rooms. That's another way you can organize and arrange students in a Zoom meeting that you might find helpful. So definitely just look through some things like this. But otherwise, going back to these tips and how-tos here, we covered so far how to remove people from a room, how to put them on hold, and also how to lock a meeting. So if you have all of these things enabled so far, you're doing the right thing. And as long as you're sharing your meeting information in Canvas, I've been teaching a workshop in Canvas, and this is some example. These are some examples of how I've been instructing other faculty to set up a Zoom module. So you can put a page here that just has some simple instructions on setting up Zoom. There's some information here like this, you know, so that's just the first thing that I have there. If you go back to modules again, I have listed the meeting ID and also provided the meeting link. And the reason why I was doing that before was just to make sure that there are two options. So one is a backup for the other, both will work. But if you want to provide a link for students, you can embed a URL here. Or you can also have the meeting ID listed. So I used a text header and listed the meeting ID here. But if you don't want to even have the meeting ID listed here, you could do what I did here, or the example that you see down here, where I actually added an external URL tool. When I added this item into my module, I used the external URL tool, and I copied that from my meeting settings, which I was able to get from here. If you go into your meetings, and if you go into your meeting, such as a group class session, you can click on that, and here is the URL. So if you highlight and right click and copy that, you can take that into your course module, and you can create a external URL, paste that URL there, and then give that a name and say something like, group class session, you know, click here. And so if you save that, what that's gonna end up looking like is something like this. And so here I had just set up two of the same types of things, the meeting ID and the link for office hours, and then the meeting ID and the link down here. So this is what I gave just as an alternate option for an example, some instructions for how to get started. And then this is just a text header here that says the Zoom links are below. Click when you're ready to start. And then I simply put the URL in here, and I don't have the meeting URL or the meeting ID posted. So if you want to make it so that students can just click on that link when the time is right, this is just another example that you can do as well. So that about wraps it up. That covers Zoom bombing and what to do in case you want to prevent Zoom bombing from happening in your course. And also just in case if something does happen, how you can manage that situation. So thank you again for watching, and good luck with your online teaching.